regarding priorities in President Bolsonaro's foreign policy. I think I can talk about a few issues. One very important is the democracy promotion and freedom promotion in our region and around the world. And that's why the issue of Venezuela has been so prominent in our action, because we really think that democracy should start in our region, and the Venezuelan situation is really a very deep case of a country that is being destroyed by a dictatorship that has to be stopped, and a regime that needs to be changed urgently. So democracy promotion is one. To contribute to economic development and growth is clearly another one. Our ministry has many responsibilities in trade and investment promotion, and that's essential for our whole project to help in creating a more open economy and a more competitive economy. So it's a big part of our task. And the promotion of our values around the world, and to bring Brazilian voice to the world, to the world stage, which we believe is the voice of the Brazilian people. Without any shame in talking, talking about things that are important for the Brazilian people. I say that a lot. We have to do things that, and I said that in Warsaw when we met, we have to do things that are important for real people and not important for other diplomats. That's what is our mandate. Diplomats too often, in the past in Brazil for sure, worked too much for each other and didn't listen a lot to the Brazilian people. And just to jump a few questions, if there is another we should talk to, I'm not sure, but if there is something that is my leading concern and ideal is to listen to what Brazilian people want and try to bring that to the world stage. Of course, it's difficult to know exactly what people want, because it's a nation of 200 million people, which is moving in different ways. But I think we can interpret very well that there is a common will, and that we're trying to respond to that will, because foreign affairs issues and values issues were so important in the platform that elected President Bolsonaro, and we have to deliver that. We cannot just, okay, now the president is elected and we'll do something else in foreign policy. No, we have to do the things that he promised he would do, because they were so important in his electoral victory. So, regarding, yes, our reconnection, so to say, with the United States. In the case of Brazil, and as was said, many other Latin American countries, but in Brazil, quite certainly, strong relationship with the United States is something that is very natural. So why was it neglected and suffocated, so to say, for a long time? Because I think there was a system in place in Brazil that wanted to keep the country closed, to keep the economy closed, and to keep more and more state control over the economy. And association with the United States is against all that, because it's an open economy. It's an open country, of course, a huge democracy. So the United States would help changing that system. So people didn't want to have a special relationship with the United States, because they wanted to keep that system of a closed economy under very close control. And now that we want the opposite, that we want an open economy, an open society, partnership with the United States is natural, and it's something that we're striving for. Just one interesting element. During three quarters of the 20th century, so from 1900 to 1975, more or less, Brazil was the country that grew the most in the world, was the economy that grew the most in the world. And in that period, the United States was the main economic partner and political partner of Brazil. Since then, our foreign policy and economic policy has tried other arrangements, and as a coincidence or not, it's a period where the Brazilian economy has stagnated, where it didn't create efficiency, where we lost competitiveness, we lost, we performed very, very badly in the economy and in other social aspects as well. So correlation is not necessarily causation, but there's clearly an element in that that we have to explore. So we need to reconnect to that very important partner. And president for its people and for the United States, because we believe that the strong United States is important for the world. If they had this leading role for so long in promoting democracy, free trade, and free institutions, that's I think what's basically what President Trump is doing. I know he has bad press. We have bad press in Brazil too, and we're sure we're on the right track. And regarding saving the West, yes, I think President Trump brought back as a leading country in the world ideas that were not there anymore, and whose land was really maybe taking Western civilization to its end, because people in so many countries didn't believe anymore that they had something worth fighting for. And I think President Trump introduces that. He thinks the idea of the land, the culture that he carries from the deep past, from Greece and Rome and everything, is something worth fighting for. And we believe that. Although, of course, in Brazil we have other heritages, which we're very proud of, but we also want to be a part of keeping the idea of the West alive and thriving. So, and lastly, a question of that Peter already answered, but President Bolsonaro really wants to visit Hungary in the near future, and I'm also pretty sure that we are everything we're doing is preparing the way for a very successful visit. We hope we can realize also that very, very shortly.
Gracias.